Jihan, welcome in the Netherlands. Thank you very much for coming. If you look at the mining world, you have become one of the biggest deliverers of hardware for the mining. How did you do that? What were the decisions you took while you now have 60% market share?
It's about very fast delivering on time on the market. And it's also about to reduce the overall cost of the miners. It requires lots of hard work and lots of engineering wisdoms. We go through a long journey to achieve this.
You delivered the right hardware at the right place. Can you describe how the company got started?
The company was started with me and my partners in 2013. I invited him to a dinner, and I described this idea and sent him some reference article on Wikipedia and the Bitcoin white paper. And my partner just take a 2 hours reading, and he decided this is a very good idea. This is definitely the thing he wanted to join with me and do it together. And that's how Bitmain started.
And what did your partner do, and what was your role? I mean, we know you as the one who translated the white paper of Satoshi into Chinese, I think.
Yeah.
And what was his input?
Yeah, actually, I think I'm kind of the business guy or the idiots in this company, and my partner is doing the very complicated ASIC chip design and all the R&D managements for this company. So that's how I just traveling around the world and meet with people, and my partner is doing the design.
And so you translated the paper of Satoshi in, when did you do that?
That was back in the end of 2011 when I was the very early days, found out Bitcoin.
And what did you do between 2011 and before you started Bitmain? How were you involved in the Bitcoin world, except translating the papers and contributing?
At that time, the Bitcoin community is very small. There were not much Bitcoiners in China, and the comments on the internet are trolling and starting to defend for Bitcoin. And because I have a very much interest in the computer science, and I also was majored in finance, and I can connect these two parts of Bitcoin together and to defend both technically and also economically. That was my job before I started to translate the white paper. I had already been defending Bitcoin.
So now Bitmain is now 400 people, and it's huge in terms of the amount of hardware you've shipped. Do you have any idea what percentage of hardware in the Bitcoin mining is from your company?
I think it's more than 50% of the...
50?
Yeah, more than 50%, but the exact market share, I'm not quite sure.
So next to that, delivering the hardware, you also have a very popular Bitcoin mining pool. What is the name, and what percentage of...
pools right now, that is andpool.com, the other one is BTC.
What market share do they have?
The total market share is close to 30%.
30%. Now... You are very important in how the capacity question of Bitcoin is going to be answered, because you have 30% voting power. How is that voting power organized? Because it's not your own, you don't own all that hardware. You organize all that hardware, but how does the voting process work?
First, I think I want to clarify that when we're talking about a consensus rule change, miner is just a part of the game. I think that the other economic players in the ecosystem also plays very important roles, but miners is also an important part of it. So volunteering, working together, you know, the hashers that who answer the mining pools. If our policy, we will take a very clear policy on what we are going to choose in terms of the consensus change voting. But if our hashers do not agree with our choice, they definitely have their they have a freedom just to switch away.
Of course, but I mean, your pool will decide one way or the other, and then if the hashers don't agree, they can leave. So it is, your vote is really important. How are you going to decide? How are you deciding to vote on that issue, on those issues?
Right now, we are working together with the Segway 2X project, and we really want to work with the economic majority to go through all this chaos and to help Bitcoin to solve the temporary transaction congestion problems.
Going to be made, you think?
When software is ready, we will upgrade our pool with the BTC One software.
End of the year, you think?
No, I think at the end of the next month.
Then we'll have the decision. Okay, so you think? Okay, so next year from when we are next year wants to give another speech about at a Bitcoin conference. Where do you think the Bitcoin world will be?
Hopefully, the Bitcoin will solve this very weird capacity problems, and to fulfill its destiny to become worldwide used.